researchers at the University of Texas have developed a remarkable device called the semantic decoder. This device can read your mind by translating brain activity into readable text. Fast forward to May 2023, a device was created at the University of Texas at Austin that can turn your thoughts and brain activity into understandable text. Not to be outdone, Meta, a major player in the tech world, recently unveiled an AI system that not only analyzes brain waves, but also predicts what a person is looking at in real time. It's like mind reading, powered by a multi-billion dollar social media giant. Are we witnessing the creation of a telepathy device through generative AI? It's a double-edged sword, a potential privacy disaster, yet a tool that could aid those unable to communicate due to illness or injury. While we're not quite at the Minority Report level of crime prediction, the ability to read and interpret brain waves is a significant step in that direction. In this video, we'll explore the university's mind-reading AI and delve into Meta's latest ventures. Hold on tight, because this is shaping up to be a game-changing journey. The university's AI tool, led by doctoral student Jerry Tang and assistant professor Alexander Huth, could be a game-changer for some individuals. The hope is that this technology can assist those who have lost the ability to communicate. Their non-invasive language decoder, a remarkable feat in the realm of generative AI, can reconstruct continuous language from perceived and imagined speech, as well as silent videos. While it's not as invasive as Neuralink, which provides clearer data but comes with higher risks, it opens up possibilities for those in need. The semantic decoder system uses non-invasive brain recordings from functional magnetic resonance imaging to analyze and interpret what a person is perceiving or imagining, turning it into understandable language. It's an amazing achievement, but let's dive into the challenges and limitations of this non-invasive approach before we get too carried away. Unlike invasive methods that involve electrodes implanted in the brain, non-invasive systems are still in the early stages of development. The team opted for fMRI because of its precise spatial specificity, allowing it to pinpoint brain activity accurately. However, there's a significant downside. It's slow in capturing changes in brain activity. The fMRI measures the blood oxygen level dependent signal, which takes about 10 seconds to respond to neural activity. Now, think about trying to decode natural language spoken at a rate of 1 to 2 words per second. It's a considerable challenge. To overcome this, the researchers used an encoding model that predicts how the brain responds to natural language. They trained the model by recording brain responses while subjects listened to 16 hours of spoken narrative stories. By extracting semantic features and employing linear regression, they created an accurate model of the brain's responses to different word sequences. In simple terms, they trained a model with over 15 hours of data per person to understand their brain activity while listening to stories in an MRI scanner. Here's where it gets more intriguing. To ensure the decoded words had proper English grammar and structure, the researchers incorporated a generative neural network language model, specifically GPT-1, an earlier version of the now well-known ChatGPT models. This model predicts the most likely words to follow in a given sequence. However, dealing with countless possible word sequences required a smart algorithm called beam search. Beam search works by analyzing brain activity and generating word sequences one word at a time. It starts with a group of the most probable word sentences, and as it analyzes brain activity further, identifies new words and generates more possible continuations for each sequence. This process gradually narrows down possibilities, keeping the most promising options for each step. By doing so, the decoder refines its predictions over time, determining the most likely words based on the person's brain activity. Now, let's consider an example. If a person hears or thinks the word apple, the decoder learns how our brains work. When we come across new words or sentences, the algorithm uses what it has learned to create a sequence of words that make sense in the language. For example, if someone says or thinks, "I ate an apple," the algorithm might generate, "I consumed a fruit," or "an apple was in my mouth." It might not be the exact same words, but it captures the meaning. Thanks to a smart encoding system, generative AI, and a clever search algorithm, scientists were able to overcome the limitations of invasive fMRI scans. With these challenges addressed, the researchers put the system to the test. They trained decoders for 3 individuals and tested them by analyzing brain responses while listening to new stories. The goal was to see if the decoder could understand the meaning. The results were remarkable. the decoded word sequences not only captured the meaning, but often matched the exact words and phrases. This means that meaningful information can be extracted from brain signals measured by fMRI. The researchers also wanted to know if different parts of the brain hold similar or different information about language. They found that diverse brain regions redundantly encode language representations, like having backup systems for language understanding. If one part is damaged, others can still process the information, preserving our language abilities, a fascinating discovery. The researchers went further and tested the system on imagined speech, crucial for understanding silent speech in the brain. The decoder successfully identified the content and meaning of imagined stories. The researchers were excited about these discoveries and the potential for decoding other types of information. Now, Meta has entered the scene, taking things to the next level. Instead of using fMRI, Meta used MEG technology, a non-invasive technique that measures thousands of brain activity points per second. With this, they created an AI system that can decode visual representations in the brain in real time. This breakthrough opens new possibilities for brain-computer interfaces without invasive methods. While the study revealed the need for improvements in motor features and participant feedback, it showcased the incredible potential of AI in understanding and interpreting the human brain. Things are about to get interesting, so let's break it down for ease of understanding. There are three parts to this system: an image encoder, a brain encoder, and an image decoder. This AI was trained on brain recordings from people, and it turns out that the signals from our brains align well with advanced computer vision systems. Now the cool part is that this AI taught itself about images without human labels using a method called self-supervised learning. According to Meta, this approach helps AI systems learn in a way that's similar to how our brains work. The artificial neurons in the AI respond to images kind of like our own neurons do. So what did Meta do with this technology? They essentially read people's minds. They showed participants an image, and the AI guessed what they were looking at based solely on their brainwaves. The catch: the AI had no clue what the actual image was, it relied purely on brain signals. The results were pretty good at guessing general things, but not so great with the nitty-gritty details. Meta says they're using this research to develop AI that thinks more like humans. Now, predicting the future of brain reading tech is tricky, but the possibilities are huge. Think about a smartphone adjusting to your mood or commands controlled by your thoughts. It's like talking to Google Assistant, but with your mind. On another note, a company called NextSense, part of Google's Alphabet, is working on earbuds that can capture brain signals. These could help monitor conditions like epilepsy and depression, track seizures, and provide insights into overall brain health. However, there's a downside. This technology could seriously mess with privacy. Imagine companies like Meta or Google knowing not only what you're looking at, but also what you're thinking. It opens the door to potential privacy issues and misuse of the technology. With Meta entering the scene, there are valid concerns about wearable tech, like the Meta VI headset, becoming a tool for decoding minds, which raises questions about the future of privacy in the next few decades. And before we move further, if you're still enjoying it so far, make sure to give this video a like and consider subscribing if you want to watch more content like this one. Meta hasn't been great at prioritizing user privacy and consent, but decoding technology to achieve mind reading or telepathy faces a bunch of challenges. It needs to get better at understanding thoughts by improving accuracy and resolution, catching onto the tone, emotion, and context. It should also work both ways, letting people send and receive thoughts. Real telepathy is still just a fantasy, and that might be a good thing. Now, onto some exciting news from university researchers. Neuroscientists at the University of Texas in Austin say they've made a big breakthrough. They used artificial intelligence to turn brain activity into words. Dr. Alexander Huth, the lead researcher, was surprised it worked so well, saying, "We were kind of shocked that it works as well as it does. I've been working on this for 15 years. This discovery is getting attention because it could potentially decode thoughts, dreams, and stuff happening in the subconscious." Professor Tim Barron from the University of Oxford praised the study's technical skill, highlighting how it can reveal deep stuff from brain scans. "Even though it was surprising at first, it makes sense that artificial intelligence can interpret human brain activity. Using AI in studies like this shows how powerful it can be. These brain decoders, backed by AI, can understand human thoughts and create understandable language and pictures, at least in controlled situations. The tech is still held back by big and expensive scanners and a long training process, but there's hope it'll get better in the future. People worry about it being misused, but it could be a game changer for those who are physically impaired. The mix of AI and neuroscience raises interesting questions. How do you think this will shape the future? Is being able to read someone's thoughts a good or bad thing? Should we put limits on this tech? Let me know what you think in the comments below. The talk about these advancements is pretty fascinating, and it's clear that AI's biggest potential shows up in scientific research.